cleaning, doing fibers, are left from the production process, and you end up with a clean product.
Yeah.
Hydrogen peroxide is a great in-between sanitizer. Rinses off really, really well. And when you don't want isopropyl or bleach fumes in your soon-to-be washroom or in action washroom, it's great for making sure something's clean. Not a good degreaser, but good for already clean bags, things like that. This is a little excessive. These bags actually come from the factory fairly clean. Worst I've found is a small single black fiber from the thread being cut at the end, I think. But it's definitely still worth doing.
Our bag is rinsed and clean. We have checked to make sure there's no other contaminants on it. You can zip it up, making sure it is the proper way. Loops are now on the outside of the bag. The zipper is here in the panel on one side.
Makes removal much easier than a lot of weight being on the bottom zipper.
Nice little Velcro protector to make sure the zipper is secure. All right, clean bags going into the machine here. The loops are going on the outside corners.
Nice full to the top mesh for effective cleaning and filtration. Very exciting.
Again, let's try that part again. Much better. Okay, perfect. That one we done with here. Yep. Here we go.
So with the single wash, we have been finding it's better to load with the impeller. With the dual wash, that's harder to say because then you have to practice loading without the impeller the second time when you go fill anyways.
And the impeller wants to, if you're filling the machine all the way up in water, wants to be about halfway between the false bottom and the top of your water surface level to have a proper vortex. Sometimes, depending on how much water you fill, you have to raise or lower the impeller just slightly. But that's why this machine is fantastic.
Thank you. Hi everyone, thanks for watching. If you found this video entertaining and you learned something today, please consider supporting us by clicking this button here. Much appreciated.